is redeemed by the blood of Jesus on the cross, and he rose from death, which we celebrated in the Easter. Man has the possibility to fall back into sin. So God has the responsibility not only to redeem man, but to stabilize his life and to empower him with his spirit and to lead him to the life of God. This great life, he does it through the power of the Holy Spirit. The Lord wants to talk to us. Shall we then prepare our hearts for it? How the life of God was given to the life of man. Because I, the Lord, lives, you also can live, and you should live. That is the great vision of God for man. In the Old Testament, we found that how God constantly trying to redeem his people through the prophets, through the kings, through the priests, through various type of ways, by 10 commandments and so on. Those who responded to God, they manifested God's power, God's life in their lives. Abraham was 100 years. When he responded, he became father of Isaac in that old age. When a man responds to God, how an ordinary man can become extraordinary? We read in Genesis chapter 26, when the land was in drought situation, the whole world was trying to find out how to handle the situation or economy. This man looked towards God and heard the voice of God and obeyed the voice, and he got 100-fold of crop. That is man walking with God. We know about David, a shepherd boy, rejected by his own family. Bible says he is like a tree which is cut off, and from the shoot, a shoot comes from the side. That is the term given for David, shoot of Jesse. But when that man gave his heart for God, hungered for God, God saw his heart. In spite of all his weakness and sin, God raised him up and made him the king for 40 years and promised that through his generation, the Messiah will be born. God is looking for, hungering for people who can join with him. But the enemy is trying to take away man and his mind and to drown him in the world. This struggle goes on. We know about Esther. Yeah, an orphan girl, but grown in a very faith-filled family. And when she committed her life to God, she became a queen. And she even sacrificed, willing to sacrifice her queenship for the sake of protecting her family, protecting her clan, save the nation. Yes, we can go on till many people in the Old Testament like Daniel, Nehemiah, Judith, and so on. When man joined with the effort of God, they brought so much life. But still man was dying in his own world, and God promised the Savior for man. And we find in the person of Jesus, number one, God himself coming down to be with man and manifested that he is Emmanuel. He is God with us. He cried, all those who are tired in life, come to me I will give you rest. In Matthew 11:28, he cried, your life is more than the life on this earth. Seek first him and his kingdom, and all that is you needed for this world will be given to you. He became the truth, sharing the truth. He said in John 6:14, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. The world, what it can do, it can kill you. He said in John 11:25-40, I am the resurrection, I am the life. Come to me, believe in me. But on the other hand, we find the power of sin leading man to horrible life of death. So Jesus has to destroy the sin from man, because if man dies with the sin, he will be thrown into the hellfire. Because our God is, though loving God, he is also God who is a judge. According to our sin, we have to face life. The consequence of sin is coming behind us. So Jesus, who came down from heaven, as today's gospel says, because he knew man, he knew what is the sin of man is going to do to him. And he loved us. And he didn't want us to perish. So he came down. And he laid down his life on the cross. And that's what in today's gospel, Jesus is explaining to Nicodemus. See, in the Old Testament, when people of Israel, when they were walking in the desert, they murmured against Moses. They were not satisfied with the life of God. What God had given to them. They were running after alcohol, running to drink the drinks that was coming from the desert trees, and running after the women like Midianites, like Canaanites women. They were running after them. They were not listening to God's voice. When they have sinned, the consequence of sin came. When they left the tent where God has kept them and they moved away from the tent, the snake that was waiting hit them, bit them, and so many people's bodies were thrown away, and their dear and near ones are crying. And so many are bitten and they are dying on the process. Moses cried to God. Then God said to him, you make a bronze serpent and lift it up. Why? He revealed a great secret. This serpent will remind you of the horrible nature of sin. This serpent will remind you the consequence of sin. You man who lives on this earth, if you don't take care of your sin, it will lead you to death. There is no other way. Check your life. And all those who looked at the snake, they began to cry, Lord, have mercy on us. The Bible says, the book of Proverbs, if anyone tries to cover up the sin, he will perish in his sin. But if he repents and cries to God, and God's mercy will come upon him. And that's what happened in the Old Testament. When Moses lifted up the bronze serpent and said, hello, that recognize you are a sinner. Recognize God can forgive you. Call upon the Lord. That is the sign of the bronze serpent. And all those who called upon the Lord, God showed mercy. Though they have sinned, though they were bitten, by the mercy of God, they were saved. So Jesus says, in the same way, now the Son of Man, about himself, Jesus says, will be raised up on the cross. Here, Jesus dies on the cross, not only to help man to know the consequence of sin, but also the love of Jesus. The Bible says in Matthew 8:17, he carried away all of us sadness, all of us sickness, all of us sinfulness upon himself. So the cross symbolizes the horrible nature of sin. He became like a worm because every man's sin came upon him, on his body. And the sin became like a dark cloud that Jesus could not see the Father's face. And he cried, "Daddy, Father, why have you forsaken me?" He became like a worm. He cried. But he poured everything for the love of you and me, for the human's sake. So the cross is not only teaches us about the horrible nature of sin, like the serpent, but it is much more than that. What is the answer, the permanent answer for man who lives in sin? The cross, come to me. The cross is calling, "I thirst." Even on the cross, the voice of Jesus is, "I thirst for you, my son. Don't roam around in your sin. Return to God. And only in God you have life. I thirst."